Hey guys, Street Smart Joker here. Today I have something really cool to show you. Something which I think some of us who've been watching the Cartoon Network shows way back in the late 90s and early 2000s will recognize these characters. I am not in touch with what is happening currently with Cartoon Network, but I'm guessing a lot of things have changed and these characters may not be in the forefront or may not be the most favorite for the kids of this generation today. But still, this is going to be a walk down the memory lane. I thought of doing a quick Gotham Comics Cartoon Network special video, and that is what it is, right? Nothing much, just going to show you a quick bunch of comics, a different set of comics from the Cartoon Network Hanna-Barbera line, which Gotham went and published, right? That's all. This is one of my favorite books. This is Johnny Bravo, and he was one of my favorite characters when I used to watch his shows, and the way how he was, how he used to go after the girls and stumble at it. Hey, I really like this t-shirt which he has, the one which says Powerpuff Girls. Anyway, that's the only book I have of Johnny Bravo for now, at least. But really cool cover. Love the cover also. Let's jump into Dexter's Laboratory. It was another favorite of mine. Obviously, nowadays I watch The Big Bang Theory and I repeat watch it. Kind of like binge watch it and watch it multiple times. But this was my favorite growing up, Dexter's Laboratory, and all the experiments that he used to do there. DD, one of my favorite other characters. So I have a couple of them here, like you guys can see, right? Let's jump into another one, which is Flintstones. So there is Flintstones and there was Jetsons, two complete opposite end of the spectrum, one from the early ages and one from the future, right? So how they tie up both these families together is something which was spectacular, and Gotham Comics did that. Although in the cover I could mostly see the Flintstones family and not the Jetsons. I think it's too different. First they take you through the, yeah, so the first story here, for example, you can see it's the Jetson story, and then I think in the second half it goes to the Flintstone story. Yeah, that's it. So that's how they do this. Oh, I really like this. Haven't got this one, but really like the cover page. Anyway, that's Flintstones here, and now let's go to another favorite one, which is Scooby-Doo and Shaggy, right? I have three comics here. This ran for multiple issues, so I could see issue number 21, 19 and 14, right? So essentially this ran for a longer time and has got much more popularity, or maybe from the other ones. The final ones which I have is of course Powerpuff Girls, and they have a lot of them. Most of these comics I've been selling, and these are all going to go away from me, so I thought why don't I show you quickly before I sell it off. This is one thing which I'm not parting with. I really like this one and I want to keep this one, but rest of it just showing you the cover ones, right? Really interesting ones. The Powerpuff Girls, right? And the mayor, of course, the town called Townsville. A lot of interesting thoughts coming to mind, but that's it, guys. So I really hope that you guys like this Cartoon Network run of comics. I'm just showing you a few pages. Oh, I forgot her character. What is the character name of this one? But really interesting and super cool comics. So if any of you guys like this when you're small, I think these guys are also some virus boys or something. Really go do pick it out, right? If you enjoyed the cartoon shows, I'm sure you will enjoy these comics as well. So thanks for watching, and yeah, until next time, bye bye.